Duke of Edinburgh funeral news, Queen faces loneliest birthday as Charles and wills to lead over royal family future. Prince Charles and William are said to hold a summit on the future of the monarchy and are planning to slim down the royal family. The future kings are set to discuss plans of a slimmed-down monarchy over the next two generations. Charles and William, with the assistance of the Her Majesty, will decide on which members of the family will retain senior royal roles and what they should do, according to The Telegraph. It comes after the Queen paid an emotional farewell to her late husband Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, during his funeral on Saturday. Due to COVID restrictions, the Queen was forced to sit alone inside Windsor Castle's St. George's Chapel as she led the royal family in mourning at the funeral of her beloved husband, the Duke of Edinburgh. And after Saturday's service, Kate Middleton acted as a peacemaker between Prince Harry and William as they shared a private chat while walking away from Philip's emotional funeral. The tender reunion after more than a year apart, came after they stood apart to walk behind their grandfather's coffin, and were set separately in the chapel. Dressed in a face mask and in somber black, it was the first time the Queen, grieving for her devoted companion of 73 years, has been officially seen in public since Philip died 8 days ago. And the Duke's coffin was lowered into the royal vault at St. George's Chapel, and was broadcast live for the first time in history. Accompanied by her loyal lady-in-waiting Lady Susan Hussey, the Queen made her way from the Sovereign's entrance in the state Bentley, as the national anthem was played, to join the solemn funeral procession. Philip's coffin, draped in his striking 12-foot personal standard and decorated with a wreath of flowers specially chosen by the monarch, and his Admiral of the Fleet naval cap and sword, was carried into St. George's Chapel. It had been lifted into place by Grenadier Guardsmen onto the rear of the dark bronze-green Land Rover Defender hearse the Duke designed himself. The Duke's association with the Royal Navy and love of the sea was a focus of the service, but in line with his wishes there was no sermon. More than 730 members of the armed forces took part in the event, but there is a limit of 30 mourners at St. George's Chapel, under COVID rules. Meanwhile, almost 14 million Brits tuned in to watch the Duke's funeral. The one-hour service was viewed by 11 million people on the BBC, 2.1 million on ITV and around 450,000 on Sky. Harry reunited with William and Charles for 2 hours after Philip's funeral. Exclusive by Matt Wilkinson. Prince Harry was reunited with brother William for 2 hours after the Duke of Edinburgh's funeral, sparking hopes of peace between them. They joined dead Charles for the first time since Harry and wife Meghan's Oprah US TV interview threatened to tear the family apart. Charles had private talks with his warring sons after the Duke of Edinburgh's funeral, and insiders say it is just what Philip would have wanted. The three met up away from the cameras following Saturday's televised service. They remained together for 2 hours at Windsor Castle as they mingled with family members on its quadrangle. Charles and William to hold summit to decide future of the monarchy. Prince Charles and his son William will lead a summit to decide the future of the monarchy following the death of the Duke of Edinburgh. They are set to discuss plans of a slimmed-down sovereignty over the next two generations, with fewer full-time working members of the royal family, what they should do and who they should be. Prince Philip's death also leaves vacant the hundreds of patronages that he held. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex's decision to move to California and step back from royal life is also thought to have prompted the move. The talks will be led by Prince Charles and Prince William will be involved in every stage, along with the Queen. A source told The Telegraph, "The question is whether you start off by deciding how many patronages and engagements there should be, and then work out how many people are needed to achieve them, or whether you decide how many people there should be, which will dictate how many engagements and patronages they can take on."